what about a good thing?
Oh, hi, and welcome to another episode of LPN Laundry. First time? Here's how it works. I play one side of an unusual record. We talk about it a little bit before. From time to time, some wacky commentary appears along the bottom of the screen, and over the course of it, I'll fold some laundry. It's not really about the laundry, but I have been told that it is oddly compelling. This week, well, it's a dark time still, right? It's been dark for quite a while. If you're watching this months, years from now, perhaps from your bunker, it is January of 2022. The Omicron variant is raging through the country, and half of the people, at least, are pretending it's not. It's still a little dark in spots, right? It's also winter, which kind of always sucks. I live in Minnesota. Here, you really gotta want it. Anyway, I thought, let's enjoy something really, really happy. Yes, it is the Strawberry Street Singers with "You Can't Have Too Much of a Good, Good Thing." Oh, yes. Pure 60s cheese. 1968, as a matter of fact. This record is just a little bit younger than me. And as you might imagine, there is, of course, a persuasive essay. For one thing, it is kind of overwritten with this whole, it's almost subliminal, hearing is believing, as if this is some sort of a, like people are going to think, are you tricking me? But hearing is believing. Let's see what they have to say for themselves. The Strawberry Street Singers' initial album is the result of detailed planning on the part of some of the music and recording world's outstanding writing, arranging, and production talents. All have united to blend 25 happy voices in a choral group to accomplish the impossible. Combine the nostalgia of the past with enthusiasm, verve, and the sound of the present. The end result is an album certain to appeal to all age levels. The title of the album, "You Can't Have Too Much of a Good, Good Thing," is prophetic, for after listening to it, you'll find you want to hear more and more of this exciting new aggregation of great singers. The Strawberry Street Singers glide smoothly from ballads to upbeat tunes with the greatest of ease to showcase talent of stellar stature. They do like their alliteration, these Strawberry Street Singers. Lizette, a haunting melodic description of a fascinating girl, is contrasted with Step to the Reel, to the Rear, the bouncy tune from the Broadway musical How Now, Dow Jones. We all remember that, right? Right. And then, just for good measure, they display even greater versatility with a stirring spiritual version of the music of the world. Another example of beautiful music and lyric wed to understanding voices is Strangers, the Richard Rodgers composition for the television special Androcles and the Lion. More will be heard from the Strawberry Street Singers in the months to come. Hearing is believing. All of this is per Mr. Sidney H. Asher. Who he is, what his qualifications are unknown to me. Perhaps I will find out afterwards. Perhaps I won't. But for now, let's see if Sidney knows what he's talking about, shall we? Oh, first up, too much of a good, good thing.
Much of a good thing is worse than none at all. Much worse than none at all.
Next up, When I'm 64. Next up, Strangers from Androcles and the Lion.
Star, we could really try.
Next up, Lisette. Next up, on the south side of Chicago.
Chicago. burst and went worse. Was its beating heart the place where action first got its start?
Back when jazz was king,
on the south side of Chicago.
Up, step to the rear. Not sure what happened there. The last few bits of the video cut off and then was replaced by an exploding tower and a giant monster. So I decided to kind of bookend it with this and do what I had been doing. You didn't miss a lot, just the last few bars of Step to the Rear from the Broadway musical How Now, Dow Jones. I think we all learned probably more about How Now, Dow Jones, and even more so about Step to the Rear than any of us really probably thought existed. Anyway, well, this was adorable overall. A little snoozy in the middle there, but a lot more adventurous musically, I think, than I expected it to be. You would think that with a cover like this, it would be adventurous, but a lot of times it gets a little up with people when you see that kind of thing, and this wasn't too bad on that. So thank you, as always, for joining me. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Make sure you can't just click the like button. Apparently, you do have to smash it. It won't break. Just make sure you smash it. If you'd like to find an archive of all episodes that I've uploaded to YouTube, you can find that at MacFugate, that's me, MacFugate.blogspot.com. Once again, that is MacFugate.blogspot.com. And I post pictures of the front and back covers of every episode, of every album, rather, that I cover. You can also connect at Facebook, facebook.com/LP Laundry. No and or ampersand in there, just facebook.com/LP Laundry. I think that just about does it. Thanks once again, and watch out for monsters.